Yay! Guys, welcome back to our 13th tutorial on the CI series, and in this video we're going to validate our login page. Okay, so I want you guys to switch to your application, that's your login page, and whenever you hit on the login page button, that is, you kind of keep on getting the main and validate login, the main control and validate login function. So just switch to your IDE, and we want to focus on the validate login function, which currently just calls the home function, and then home function loads in the dashboard, and then the dashboard, and then the home page. Okay, so to handle this, we want to capture the fields in here, the two fields in here, that's the username and password, and then we will go into our database and check if the user first exists. Okay, and then the next thing that we're going to do is to check if our password in here is equal to the hash password that's in our database. Well, sounds so complicated, but relax, the concepts are just so easy to grasp. Okay, so let's switch back to our IDE, and then we want to capture the password field. That password, I'm setting it into a variable, is equal to this input post, and then password that's coming from our form. Okay, and then I want to set our username here into a credential array. So let me do credential is equal to array, and then what I'm going to do is to set the first key here to our username, our database field. Okay, username in here, username. And then we're going to grab the input post of username that comes from the form. That's the username of the person who's trying to access your application. Sounds so easy, okay? So that's a key, and the value in here is going to be this input post of username. Okay, cool. So at this point I want to start querying my database to see first if the user exists. Okay, if the username that's provided in the user's field actually exists, and I'm using my username here, O-B-R-I-E-N, O'Brien. So I want to check if the username in here is existing in our database. So to do that, I'll just call my model. Okay, so I can load my model right in here, this load model, and then main model. Okay, main. I'm going to use main model because this is not running under any other specific section of my application, any other model. So I want to maintain the general things under the main controller and the main model, but this one is not as necessary though, because I can just do away with it, because we're already preloading our model up here as an array of models. Okay, so that explains everything. Why I'm not going to keep on being redundant and typing it all over the functions. Okay, so I'll just go straight away and call my model. Okay, so this main model, and then the function that I want to query the my database. Okay, and return the result back to my controller. So this main model, And then let me say get login. Okay, get login. And then I want to pass in my credentials, my username. I want just to check if the username exists in the database. Okay, so I'll pass in credentials. Okay, that's now sounds so so easy. So what I'm going to do is just to create this function. I'm going to create this function in my model, okay, in my main model, and then query my database and see if that user exists. Let me just find myself a free space in here. Okay, so let me do function credentials. So already I copied it, so just paste it. And again, that's not necessary. Okay, so function get login, and then what I'm going to do in here is to first, I want to first extract. I want to extract credentials, okay, so that I can use the username as a variable. So extract credentials, and then I want to query my database where the username is equal to the current user that's trying to log in. Well, let me show you that from my SQL. So use training, and then I can say select star from users. This will just give me a general query of all the users that are currently contained in my table. But I want to introduce a where condition where the username field in here, the username field, okay, a username. So username is equal to, let me use my current username is equal to, we're going to quote it, it's a string, so we have to quote it. So is equal to my current user. Okay, so it still returns the record, because I currently have one record by the same username. So I further want to modify this to include the password as well. So and password is equal to my current password. So let me just copy field, so is equal to, let me paste, no need to quote, it comes with the quotes in the first place. So is equal to that password, that hash password. So the product of the query will still give you the same record, okay, the same user, the same record. But if you had 1,000 or 1,000,000 other users, it will just filter to the username where username is equal to O'Brien, because if you think of it smartly, when we were creating our users table, we created our username field to be unique, which means we don't expect duplicates in the first place. Okay, so let's just switch here and start querying our database. And to query our database, after extracting our credential, we want to start querying our database by selecting all the records. So this DB select, and then all records is star. Okay, all records is star. But you guys will, with time, come to realize that this DB select star is not necessary in Code Igniter, because by default we expect to select all the records. So you can ignore this. You can ignore this this command. Okay, this DB select command, or you can just leave it. no harm. Okay, so this db select star, and then this db form. Now here's the table. I want to specify which table that you want to use in this query. So this db from users, okay, and then our where condition comes in here. So this db where, okay, so where username, we're going to use our username field. So username, and then because we have already extracted our credentials which just pass in our, which just contains our username as an array, okay, as a value within the array, just an item within the array. What we're going to do here is just to pass in, we're going to pass in the username in here, username. So this comes from our user, what the user enters in the username field in here, username. Okay, so we're capturing that and then passing it into our query, which means it's already dynamic. Whatever the user types into the username field is what we're going to check in here. So at this point our query is done. Okay, nearly the same, actually the same thing that we have here. Sounds so simple. Okay, actually it's this simple. So what we're going to do is just to assign this to a query. Query is equal to this db get. Now this one returns the query, and then we want our controller to know that at least we found a record in our database that matches our username. Okay, so what we're going to do in here is to say if query, and then you can introduce number of rows. So if query number of rows, that is num underscore rows, that's the number of rows that's returned from the query app here. Okay, so if query number of rows is greater than zero, you can take that is equal to one. So is equal to one. The reason why I'm using double equal sign is because I'm comparing. Okay, this is a comparison. I'm not assigning one to the query number of rows. I'm comparing. So if you compare, use double, right? Yeah, use double equal sign, or just triple. The triple equal signs check on the type. Okay, that's the data type, whether it's a string or an integer, any other, just the data type, and then compares them. So that if you have a quoted one is a string. Okay, if you have a quoted one and just an integer one like the one I currently typed, they'll return two different things. Okay, string is different from an integer. So so we want to compare if the number of rows is equal to one or just greater than zero. But actually, when we find a user that matches our search criteria, by default the result will be one. Okay, the result will be one because we already set our database not to contain duplicates. Yeah, understandable. So just understand that use that triple equal signs to check the type, and yeah, the type, that's the type and dimension, that's the type and the value itself, if they match, plus the type and everything. I don't know if in future these guys will introduce an extra equal sign to check if the programmer is insane or something. You don't know what these guys introduce to you, if the programmer is insane and if he is intoxicated with something serious like caffeine. You never know. Okay, so if query number of rows is equal to one, then what are we going to do? We're going to return query query result, okay? Query result. Else, we'll just return else, okay, return false. Okay, so false will mean that the query isn't successful. Okay, fairly understandable, pretty much. Okay, so this is done. At this point, we are done. So what I'm going to do is just to switch back to my model, and then instead of having these, I just want to assign this. I want to assign this into a variable called called result, okay? I want to assign this into a variable called result and say result is equal to this main model. Mm-hmm. Now you know, guys, it's not complicated. I've assigned my username search into a variable so that we just check if the user that the username that's currently typed in our login field here is, get it, is in the database. Wow, I know that's programming. Everything here is interesting because you can just make your logics work. Okay, so instead of having this in here, I just don't want to blow everything at once. I want you to understand it bit by bit. I'm going to do away with the end of statement. That's my semicolon, and then I'm going to wrap this into an if statement. Okay, so if, okay, if our search is successful, okay, at this point, if our search is successful, want to do, so in the first place, if our search is not successful, else we'll need an else here, and then what we're going to do there is just to reload our login page, okay, we're going to load our login page and tell the user that you're trying to mess up with our system. And then give them a chance. It's always fair to give somebody an extra chance to prove if they really have credentials to access our application. Okay. Oh, I'm talking much. I didn't know that I could talk this much. So, if a result is returned from the database, or that is our, if our query is successful, what we're going to do here is just to do a for each loop in here, for each, okay? So for each result, the variable result up there, this one over here, for each result as a row, okay? For each result as a row, let's just expand this. For each result as a row, we want to assign the not the username anymore, but we already checked the username and we already know it's existing, right? Now what you're going to do in here is just to check our password field. That's the next thing to do. So far our user already exists, the current user that's type in here already exists at this point, if you follow the logic keenly, okay? So at this point, what you're going to do is just to create in a variable, let me say stored hash, that's what's now in the database. So stored hash is equal to row, okay, the row up here, that's coming from the result, so the row, the row password, okay? Password. Do I give you time to absorb that? Maybe. When I take just a sip of coffee. Nearly running empty. Okay. Already sunk into your brain? Probably, but you can pause the video and understand, but we have to continue. So I was told hash in here is equal to the row of password. In other words, I was told hash is equal to this value in here, the hashed field of the username. So and I want you guys to understand that bcrypt is a one, okay? Bcrypt is a one-way hashing algorithm, so that you can't just get this hashed password back to a text equivalent. You can't do it. You can take the next few years struggling to just crack the single password here, probably several years, 10 or 20, maybe 50 years, just to hack this password. Okay, so what we're going to do in here is just to compare, because bcrypt is just a one-way hashing algorithm, just going to compare the password that has been entered here. Okay, we're going to compare this password with the stored hash. That's our database hashed value returned from the user. Okay, returned from the database, which just matches our user. So what we're going to do here is to call our bcrypt hashing algorithm, right? Get it? So this bcrypt, so what we're going to do here is to compare our hashing, okay? So this there's this function called check, okay? Check hash, right? Check hash. Do I need to confirm? Check password. Check hash. Check password. Don't have to check hash. Yeah, we need to check password. So we're going to check password. So we're going to check password and then compare it with our hashing. Is it the other way around? Checking a hash against the password. Is checking the password, yeah, exactly. Is checking the password, right? I think so. Let's just try it out. Just checking the password in here. Want to check the password that's coming from our form against what's stored in the database. So this bcrypt, you have to check _password, okay? And this takes on two parameters within the parentheses, and then the first one is going to be, we can say this input post of, if you understand that well, this input post of password, this one here, but we can just pass in our password, okay? We can just pass in our password in there, but you can as well do this input post of password, but that means, okay, that means that you have to do away with this because it won't be necessary. So we're going to check our password. That's what's coming from the form, that what the user has entered, or what the user that we already confirmed exists in our database has already entered as the password, okay? So we have narrowed down, we already know that the user exists. Now we just want to compare the password, okay? So what we're going to do here is just call this bcrypt check password, and then we're going to check what's coming from the form against what's stored in the database. That's the stored hash. And then once more in here, we need to just wrap this with an if, okay? So can just wrap this with an if. Okay, so Now we're checking the password, which means an if and else again. Okay, so which means if the password is not equal to what is stored in the table in our database, then there's something still wrong. This guy must have stolen or hijacked somebody's username somewhere and then is trying to legally access the system. And we have to deny access, right? Oh. I think everything here is now self-explanatory. So if this bcrypt check password, and then we're passing in our password field, or just this input, and then post of password, okay? They're still the same things. Yeah, the same story. So just want to check the two. I'm taking much time explaining this because you can chew blackout if you don't get it right, okay? And you'll have a pretty long day, and I want to reduce your 2 days of correcting this into 3 minutes of explanation. So at this point, we already know that everything is working. So I think we should just create our topic for the next lesson in here. Yeah. So here we're going to set our session variables. Set session variables. Okay, at this point, we are going to set our session variables so that you can track who's logged in, that's by username, okay, until they log out. Or you can just give them some reasonable amount of time to use the application, and then you can check if there's no action within a specific time, then you can I can just log them out because they're probably away or not care for the system. So, and then this is the point that we're going to call in our home page because everything is successful. Okay, so this home, but we can't just entirely call our home page this way. We can do it, but we can do it as a redirect, okay? So we can redirect to main/home. This just the controller/function. Everything here is just understandable. Else, now let's handle the else bit, and we have 2 else's to handle, okay? So else, the first else. So the else bit in here, we'll have to redirect our user back to the login page, and then we have to provide a message. You have to let them know that they are doing something wrong. At least that will be fair, not just letting them clicking the login button several times without success. You have to let them know. So at this point, we want to set our flash data. This is another part that you should know. Flash data. So flash data is available when the page reloads. When you redirect a page for the first time, and then after that, it gets cleared from your browser. You don't want to maintain several other sessions. So we just set a flash data, and then after loading the page, the flash data will get cleared from your browser automatically. Okay, so let's do that. So at this point, we'll say this is a keyword with a $. So this session, okay, set _flash data, okay, flash data and then setting your flash data will take on yet another two parameters within the parentheses. So I'll do this session set flash data, and then I'm going to set my flash data in here to be error. That's the error, and then the message itself. Okay, invalid login credentials. Okay, so this will appear as a message. And then what are we going to do next? Okay, so if you check our login file in here, you'll know that at a point we're displaying, we're echoing our error here. And first we're checking if it's set, because we just don't want to create a form for multiple forms, that is. So if it's set, we're going to call in a Bootstrap class, and inside the Bootstrap class here has a class of label, and label danger can tell what that is. Okay, label danger, something reddish. Okay, so we're going to echo in the error message here, and that is the error message that we've set in here. So this will just be available, we've set it in our session, which means we don't have to pass it, okay, at this point, because we are going to reload the, not even reload, we're going to redirect this page. Yeah, we're going to redirect this page to main/login. Okay, that's the function that loads our login page. Okay, so we're going to do redirect to, let me do site URL, and then providing here my controller main/, get it? Okay. Progressing, we are. And then the same thing, this one also should go in here, because our login is not successful. Okay. Shift, move it back a bit. Okay. So that is that. So we want to redirect this to main login, or just redirect to login error. I think we should redirect this to login error. Yeah. So which means we're going to do a search URL and then login error. How many minutes? Okay. So search URL main, but let me just do this to be a login error. Login error, then I have to do that right over here, because I need to do a custom login error to capture my errors as well. So let me do that after my function in here. Let me just do function login, let me just paste it, login error. And then what I'm going to do here is just to, now I want to grab now this session variable that I've set. And let me just put that into data. Let me do an data error is equal to this, okay, session, right, session. And then we are not going to set now. Just going to say flash data, right, and then error. Good. And then what we're going to do again is just to now set our title title. Okay, I'll just maintain my British accent today. I wanna be a Briton. Okay. Or no, at all. Let's keep our American title accent. Or title, that's now a Lu accent. title, actually in Lu we'll just call it title. Let me keep title. Okay, so title is equal to, just say login error. Login error. And then this load view, and then our view name, which is just login, and then let's just go ahead and pass in our data end here. I think that's now understandable that you're setting our session flash data in here, and then passing it to our login view again. Yeah, you guys can understand this. So I want us now to go and test our login form if it's working. So what's left here is to introduce our session variables. So our session variables mean to store the logged in user, that's the username and the rest of the details that we provided in here, what's necessary. Plus we can create an extra table to handle other things and then just retrieve the information and display it back to our application. So things set, hope it works. Been a coding session, a real coding session. So so let's just switch to our browser and then see if our logic will work out. Okay, so I want to use my current username, that's what was in the database, and something that's not related to my password, then see. Okay, works nicely, invalid login credential. But if you recall, we set our flash data, that means that if you try to reload the browser, the flash the message won't be here anymore, it's gone. And yeah, so we can just come back here and just try our password. Let me try where my head is. Okay, got it. That means that if I do Windows key and this, you can always do Windows key and space to change your language. Okay, that will in turn change your your keyboard layout. That is where it is. No, currently at is the major reason why a million people change their passwords daily. Probably located on top of two or next to the enter button. Just don't know unless you try out. So let's try to log in now. Okay, we set our password to K3. Well, let me just copy it. I can trace it to where we created our. Okay, here it is. Just need to copy it and then switch here, paste, and then login successful. Now I can update and store my password, and then we meet in the next lesson. Okay. To see if we can set our session variables, our session vars. So just as a recap to our nicely working login, here's what we did. First, we came here and then we assigned what's coming from our login form. Okay, we assigned what's coming from our login form, the username field, that is, we assigned it into a variable, but we said that this is not necessary because you can just pass in this one here, and it will still work out. Okay, it will still work out. Come on, don't need to prove a thing. It's still the same logic. Okay, so we did that, and then we captured our username. We captured our username and then set it into array called credentials. Okay, understandable. And then we went ahead into our model and then we extracted it. So which means you can just do your username here. So if you don't want to go through the extraction process and the rest of the things, you can just do username is equal to this input first of username. Okay, and then you pass it in here, come to your main model, then pass it in here again. Okay, and then don't have to extract this because just the same variable, and then pass it in there. Logic's flowing. That's now being dynamic. You don't have to stick to that kind of code that you just picked from the internet and then you map it into your application. No, that's what most people do. They're not even creative, and I don't want you to be like that. Okay, so that is that. So so we assign our username into a variable, that's what's coming from the form, and then we pass it into our model as a to query our model, okay, in the where condition, and then get the username. And then after getting the username, you return the query result, which means you're trying to return all the selector. We're going to return all the columns in the database. Okay, you can do select username here if you want only to return the username, but you want to return all the rows, because if you check, we went ahead in here and use the password row, not the username row. Okay, understand? And then we called in our bcrypt hashing algorithm, and then we just used a function within the bcrypt hashing algorithm called check password, and then we checked our password and provided what the user has typed in the form here. Okay, against the password that the user has typed in the form, against what's stored in the database, because in bcrypt you can't get the text equivalent of your hashed password. You can't, because it's a one-way hashing algorithm. Now you understand. Okay, so why don't we meet in the next lesson and then see if we can set our session variables. We already set our next lesson problem in there. So we go ahead and set our session variables, and now that we have logged in, after that I think we'll just see if we can destroy our session. Okay, if you destroy your session, which means that you're going to log out. That's another way of just saying that you're going to log out. Okay, you're going to destroy your session. When you destroy your session, all the session variables that you're going to set will be destroyed. Not necessarily just the login. All the session that you've created will be destroyed. So we'll have to set our session variables, destroy all our session, and then go ahead and introduce extra security features in here. This is secure, but somebody can steal your inject SQL into into the user's form, okay, and just inject SQL and then dump your database, okay, your database somewhere. So we're not still that secure, but we'll talk about cross-site scripting in the next few lessons. Sanitizing your data, everything, you'll have to talk about them. It's part of our security, you know. So meet me in the next lesson as we try to set our session variables. See ya then.